Jim in Chicago. It says you disagree with me. What's up, Jim?
Good afternoon, Tom. You know, I was driving home today, and I was listening to you on the car radio, and I have to warn you, I am a conservative, so don't get mad at me or hang up on me. But
why would I do that?
Well, if I hear one more time about Mitt Romney's wife's Cadillac, first of all, a Cadillac is a piece of junk. When that story first broke and they said his wife's got two Cadillacs, I said, that's all?
Well, at least they're American-made cars, in his defense.
Well, I mean, you know, what is a Cadillac? That's like a Chevrolet with lock nuts.
But you're right. But the point wasn't his wife's second Cadillac. The point was, actually, there were a couple, but, you know, one was he was like, yeah, my wife has an American-made car. In fact, she's got two Cadillacs. It's the average person doesn't have two Cadillacs. I think that was the first point. The second was the average person doesn't hire a lobbyist to lobby the city to give them a zoning variance so they can build an elevator in their garage so that they can fit more than one Cadillac in it.
Okay, can I say something about that, though?
Please.
There's one thing interesting about him blowing money on all this very extravagant stuff.
Well, this is not a high level of extravagance, actually.
It's his money.
Well, I would say that he stole much of it. I would say that those people who worked at that steel factory that his company bought up, sucked out, stole the pension money, fired those people, and shut the thing down and made a huge profit on it when it went bankrupt, I would say that he stole that money from those people.
Okay, well, let me ask you.
So you could say it's his money. He stole it fair and square. I would agree with you on that. But I don't see how you could say that he earned it. All Bain Capital and any of these vulture capital firms, all they do is manipulate the tax code.
Okay, well, let me ask you this then. Do you think that any of these Democratic politicians are broke? Do you think the Obama family don't have boatloads of money? Do you think Nancy Pelosi...
Barack Obama had student loans that he was paying off when he was a United States senator. He didn't make serious money until his book started selling
because
just before the campaign,
really,
and he's made about $1.5 million from the sale of his books. And plus, he makes $400,000 a year as president of the United States. That's it.
Not to rip on the guy, but he's never really had a job, okay?
What, you think being a professor of a law school is not a job?
You think being
a United States senator is not a job?
Okay.
John McCain then's never had a job.
Well, the ex-House
Lindsey Graham's never had a job.
The ex-House Speaker, Nancy Pelosi, they are very, very, very wealthy. Very wealthy people.
Nancy Pelosi is not running for president. Secondly, we're talking about Mitt Romney, the guy who made $350 or $400 million ripping off American workers, sending their jobs overseas, shutting down their companies, and now is stashing his money, according to Vanity Fair, just came out in the last couple of days, stashing his money in the Caymans, in Luxembourg, in Ireland, and Switzerland. And you're going to try and tell me that that qualifies this guy to be president of the United States?
Who is Vanity Fair? Who are they?
Vanity Fair has an incredible record of investigative reporting. If you're denying the facts, you're going to have to take it up with the Romney campaign because they're acknowledging those facts.
All I can say is
they are not disputing what's in the Vanity Fair report or the Associated Press report that went along with it.
Well, what I could say to you about Mitt Romney and all his money and all of his bank accounts, it seems like this man can handle money and make it grow, and that's what we need in this country.
We need a bankster who steals money from people to be president of the United States.
Whatever. I don't think the Obama administration...
That's like saying that we need an oil guy to be president of the United States. Oh, by the way, what's he going to do as president? He's going to invade the second oil-richest nation on Earth, Iraq. That worked out really well, didn't it?
Okay. Can I run an experiment by you for this country?
Sure.
Let's do this. Let's cut the country in half, and half of the country lives by the Democratic idealism, and the other half lives by the Republican ideism. And you can live wherever you want to live. We'll have red states and blue states.
Jim, I'll tell you, that's already happening. And right now, the net transfers to the red states The red states, on average, for every dollar in taxes that they pay into the federal government, they're getting back about $1.12, $1.15, in some cases as much as $1.20, like down in Mississippi. Whereas the blue states, for every dollar that they pay into the federal government, they're getting back 70 cents, 80 cents, maybe 90 cents. There is a massive transfer of wealth going on right now from the blue states to the red states. The red states are massive welfare recipients at the same time that their governors are running around going, independent, individual responsibility. It's all about individual responsibility. But they're on welfare, the red states. The experiment that you're describing has already happened, Jim. Take a look.
Okay, well, I'm a nice guy, and if it ever does really go down and happen like that, I will personally help you move to the red state, because that's where you'll want to live.
Why would I want to live in a poor state like Mississippi?
Because there'll be no crime, and
because there'll be no crime. There, you know,
right.
Mississippi has one of the
Be working and not making excuses. You know what, Tom? I got 11 people in my family. I got 11 people
You're
in my family.
You're seriously telling me that poor states, the red states, these states that are living in poverty, where you've got, you know, very, very high rates of people on Medicaid, because you have to be poor to qualify for Medicaid. That those states are the places where it's easiest to get a job? Are you seriously trying to tell me that?
Yep, I am.
Where do you live?
I live in Illinois.
It says Illinois, yeah. I would suggest that you visit Mississippi. I'll bet you never... You know, I lived in Atlanta for 14 years, 13 years. I can tell you about the South, and I can tell you about the poor South versus the wealthy South, because Atlanta was the wealthy South. And you don't want to be, or for that matter, the poor, you know, poor Appalachia. I've been in West Virginia. The poor Midwest, you know, I grew up in Michigan. I've been watching my own state being torn apart by insane trade policies. I mean, you don't want to be living in a state that is practicing Republican economics, Romney economics. Romney economics only works for bankers like Romney.
You know, This health care bill that everybody's so proud of, I vote in the 8th district in Cook County, Illinois.
Mm-hmm.
And we called our congresswoman's office, Melissa Bean's office. Mm-hmm. We called her office at least 10 times and asked her how she was going to vote on that health care bill.
You mean on the Romney Obamacare bill?
Whatever you want to call it, that's fine. I'm going all the way back to when the bill was first introduced.
Right, the Heritage Foundation Romney Obamacare bill.
It went on the floor late Sunday night. They all voted for it.
Yeah.
You know, prior to that happening, I called her office.
Here's what baffles me, Jim. Why is it that the conservatives came up with this legislation? The Heritage Foundation promoted it. Newt Gingrich was its biggest promoter in the 90s as Speaker of the House during the Clinton administration as an alternative to Hillary Care. Then Mitt Romney took it in 2002 or 3 or 4 and put it into place in Massachusetts. It's all been Republican all the way, and now the Republicans hate it. I'm baffled.